Now we'll revise the dictation words. So the dictation words can come as missing letters. The dictation words can come as jumbled words, rearrange the words. So please be attentive. Okay, we'll start with the first word, reside, R-E-S-I-D-E, reside. Vowed, V-O-W-E-D, vowed. Foster family, F-O-S-T-E-R, F-A-M-I-L-Y, foster family. Window pane, W-I-N-D-O-W, P-A-N-E, pane. Crawling, C-R-A-W-L-I-N-G, crawling. Just now I told you, don't fidget with your gadgets, don't on your camera. Please be attentive in the class. Dictation words can come as missing letters, can come as jumbled words. So please be attentive in the class. Okay, quietly, Q-U-I-E-T-L-Y, quietly. Tingled, T-I-N-G-L-E-D, tingled. Frightened, F-R-I-G-H-T-E-N-E-D, frightened. W-R-A-P-P-E-D, wrapped. Supposing I give you the missing letters, W-R-A-dash-dash-E-D, W-R-A-P-P-E-D. So this is the way it goes. Okay, children, so please keep in mind. Next, we move on to the synonyms. Muskrat, a rat-like animal with thick brown fur. A rat-like animal with thick brown fur. Okay, now, please keep in mind the synonyms could be asked. Give another word for. Synonyms could be asked for. Give another word for. A rat-like animal with thick brown fur, muskrat. A rat-like animal with thick brown fur, muskrat. So you must know the meaning for both. If I ask you, give another word for a rat-like animal with thick brown fur, you must know to answer muskrat. If I give you, give the synonym for muskrat, you must know to answer a rat-like animal with thick brown fur. So you must know both the meanings. Okay, next, whimpers. Make small sounds of pain and fear. Make small sounds of pain and fear. Okay. So, give another word for make small sounds of pain and fear, whimpers. Okay, so this meaning also you should know, whimpers meaning also you should know. So, give another word for make small sounds of pain and fear, you need to click whimpers. Understood? Okay, so now, disrespectfully, scornfully. Scornfully, disrespectfully. Okay, so sluice, a channel for surplus water to drain out. Next, supported, braced. All right, so you must know the meaning for braced, supported. Supported, braced. So I might give another word for. So children, please keep in mind, you must know both the meanings of this lesson. Right, beaten, battered. Beaten, battered, or bruised. Okay, so you must be thorough with all the meanings. You must know all the synonyms by heart. Singe, burn. Okay, now we'll move on to the antonyms. Okay, whimper, praise. Whimper, praise. Scornful, respectful. Scornful, respectful. Danger, safety. Danger, safety. Listen, ignore. Listen, ignore. Whisper, shout. Whisper, shout. Whimper, praise. Scornful, respectful. Danger, safety. Listen, ignore. Whisper, shout. All right. Now, children, please keep in mind the true or false, which is given here, it will be asked in fill in the blanks. It will be asked in match the following. So you should know the lesson by heart. You should know who said to whom, whose words were spoken to. So for example, if I say, Rikki Tikki wanted to kill dash Chuchundra. So, but the answer is false. I might give you all the options. You need to click the correct answer. Rikki Tikki wanted to kill the family, Teddy's family, right? Okay. So Nag and Nagina were whispering in Teddy's bedroom. False. Nagina laid eggs in the cabbage patch. Okay, remember when I was taking the lesson for you, what did I say? Nagina had laid eggs in the melon bed. Sometimes I give you in the fill in the blanks also. Nagina had laid eggs in the dash bed, melon bed. So you must know to answer if it comes in true or false, if it comes in fill in the blanks, if it comes in match the following. You need to know perfectly well the answer. Nag was coiled around the bath. Nag was not coiled around the bath. This is false. Nag was coiled around the water jar. Okay. Rikki Tikki bit Nag's head. Okay. It's true. Okay. Now, I might give you Rikki Tikki bit Nag's tail. Okay. So, there's a change there. So, you need to read the question which is given to you in your Google Forms, and you need to click the correct answers. Okay, so the big man shot Nag. True. So I might change and ask you, the big man shot Nagina. Okay, so you please be careful in clicking the correct answer. Read 2-3 times, you read the answer and then you click the correct answer if it comes in Google Forms. Okay, children. Now we'll move on to ERC. But are you sure that there is anything to be gained by the people who said these words and to whom? Nag said these words to his wife, Nagina. Remember, Nag did not have any thought of killing anyone. It was only Nagina who instructed her husband Nag to kill. So that's what he said these words. But are you sure that there is anything to be gained by the people? So is there anything that do we gain by killing those people? So who said these words and to whom? Nag said these words to his wife Nagina. What does the hesitation of the speaker to kill people tell us about the speaker? The hesitation of the speaker to kill people tells us about the considerate nature of Nag. Yes, do we all agree with that? That is what he has asked this question to Nagina. We do not gain anything by killing people. So this is his considerate nature of Nag towards people, or sparing nature of Nag. Okay. And if he fights, oh Rikki, who said these words? Rikki Tikki, the baby mongoose, spoke these words to himself. Now children, I might ask you, who said these words? I might ask you these words, who is he? He is Nag, the king cobra. Supposing if I ask you, he is Nagina, the queen cobra, you must know to answer it is true or false, or if it is yes or no type given in your Google Forms, you must know how to click it. Read the question correctly so that you click the correct answer. And if he fights, oh Rikki, who said these words? Rikki Tikki, the baby mongoose, spoke these words to himself. Who is he? He is Nag, the king cobra. What does the speaker mean by oh Rikki? Oh Rikki expresses the mongoose's fear of fighting the 5-foot snake and being defeated. All right. Now we'll move on to the question answers. What did Rikki Tikki hear when he was in the garden with Chuchundra? Rikki Tikki heard. Okay. So here it is here. And here you'll have to add D here. So Rikki Tikki heard the dry scratch of the snake's scale on brickwork. when he was in the garden with Chuchindra. Now children, this question might come for question answer, this question might come for fill in the blanks, this question might come for true or false also. So you must know to answer it correctly. Okay, one more time we'll revise this. That is what I'm saying. Rikki-tikki heard the dry scratch of the snake's scale on brickwork when he was in the garden. Supposing if I give you when he was in the kitchen, you must know whether to answer whether it is true or false. No, it is in the garden with Chuchundra. Okay, so one more time we'll revise this. Please keep in mind, what did Rikki-tikki hear when he was in the garden with Chuchundra? What did he hear? He heard the dry scratch of the snake's scale on brickwork when he was in the garden with Chuchundra. What instruction did Nagina give Nag about killing the big man? Nagina instructed Nag to quietly go inside the house, remembering to bite the big man first, who killed Krait, the small snake. Now, as I was taking the lesson for you also, I was telling you, it was Nagina who instructed her husband to kill the family members. Now, what Nagina is saying now, first to go and kill the big man. So this also could be asked in true or false. Nagina instructed Nag to go and kill Teddy first, true or false. Okay, now Nagina has instructed Nag to go and kill Alice, that is the mother. True or false? Like this, questions will be asked in your Google Forms. You must know to answer it correctly. Read the question correctly and you will be able to answer. See, one more time, I will revise this answer with you. What instruction did Nagina give Nag about killing the big man? Nagina instructed Nag to quietly go inside the house, remembering to bite the big man first, who killed Krait. Okay, so why did Nagina want the house to be empty? Nagina wanted the house to be empty as they would be king and queen of the garden as soon as their eggs hatch in the melon bed. Their children would need to be quiet in the room. Now children, as I've already told you, this hatch in the melon bed, it came in true or false also. Now I will twist the questions and ask you, Nagina wanted the house to be empty as they would be king and queen of the garden. So here there will be a twist also here. So you must know to read the question and click the correct answer. Okay, so one more time I will go through this question answer. Why did Nagina want the house to be empty? Nagina wanted the house to be empty as they would be king and queen of the garden as soon as their eggs hatch in the melon bed. Their children would be quiet in the room. Supposing I give you, their grandchildren would be quiet in the room. True or false? So you must know to answer. See, the correct answer is their children would be quiet in the room. Okay, so like this, I will be asking you questions. So you must know the story by heart. How did Rikki-tikki attack Nag? Nag had coiled himself around the water jar with his head away from the jar. Rikki-tikki made sure that he attacked Nag's head with all his might at a single stroke. Okay. Why did Rikki-tikki feel dizzy when he was fighting Nag? When Rikki-tikki was fighting with Nag, he was beaten to and fro, back and forth, up and down, and around in great circles on the floor. Hence, he felt dizzy. Why do you think Nag was trying to avoid killing Rikki-tikki? Nag was not very keen on killing anyone. Nag, note this point, children. It might be asked for true or false. Nag was very keen on killing everyone. True or false? So Nag was not very keen on killing anyone. Okay, so like this, the questions will be twisted and asked. You must know to answer. Nag was not very keen on killing anyone. But even when Nagaina explained the need for more room, Nag thought that if the big man and the woman were killed along with the child, Rikki Tikki would vacate the garden. Okay, so who was more cunning? Nag and Nagaina. Now they're asking. Nagaina was more cunning as she was the one who instructed Nag to kill. Okay, remember, Nagaina and Nag were both whispering to each other. It was Nagaina who was telling her husband Nag to kill the big man, right? And she was plotting a sketch to kill Teddy's family and inherit the house. Remember, Nagaina had, and she was very cunning that she wants to take the house for her children. Okay. And she wanted to take the house and the garden. So I will ask you, Nag and Nagaina wanted the house and the garden. True or false? I might ask you. So you must know to answer it correctly. Nagaina was more cunning as she was the one who instructed Nag to kill. So read, children, and you will be able to understand. Okay. So it was only Nagaina who plotted the sketch to kill Teddy's family. Keep that in mind. Do you think Rikki Tikki was brave? Okay. Yes. Rikki Tikki was brave. Rikki Tikki used to take a walk around the house every night. Now I might give you, Rikki Tikki used to take a walk around the house every morning. True or false? False. So you must know how to answer, because it states that Rikki Tikki used to take a walk around the house every night. So as soon as Rikki Tikki heard a sound on the window pane, he became very alert. Now I might ask you, Rikki Tikki became very alert. He started to sleep. True or false? You must know to answer. The correct answer is, he became very alert when he heard a sound on the window pane. Okay. He knew that he has to protect Teddy's family from the snakes. Rikki Tikki did not hesitate to fight back with the snake, and that's how he is known to be brave. Okay. I might ask you, Rikki Tikki was brave or frightened? Rikki Tikki was brave. You must know to answer. Rikki Tikki was brave. Okay. Now we move on to the next part of our course book exercise, where we are dealing with colloquial language. Here, the writers, they write the colloquial languages so that it will be easy for the readers to read. Okay, a colloquial word or a phrase is used in the informal language. Now, for example, this little chap has saved our lives now. So here, it can be a boy. Okay, but in this lesson, it is a mongoose, right? So chap is a colloquial word used for a person. Okay, now we move on to the matching the colloquial form. Now, children, listen. Chatterbox, a talkative person. So I might give another word for chatterbox, a talkative person. So you must know both the meanings, a talkative person, chatterbox. Chatterbox, a talkative person. Okay, so this is the colloquial form where the writers write and the readers read it so that it would be easy to understand. Okay, you call yourself a couch potato. You call yourself a lazy person. I might give this in sentence formation also. Okay, so you must know. Sheila called herself a couch potato. She called herself a lazy person. So you must know the meaning for couch potato. Okay. My gran came home. My grandmother came home. You must know how to change it into the colloquial form. Right. Got to. Okay. I saw her kid playing near the garden. I saw a child playing near the garden. So this might come for sentences also you must know to answer. This is the colloquial form. Okay, mom, mother. Okay, fine. Now we move on to the grammatical part of our lesson. Pronouns. Pronouns are words that are used in place of nouns. Now, I, you, we, he, she, it, they, them, her and him. Now, children, please keep the concept in your mind for grammar. Only then you will be able to understand and apply the correct pronoun for the given sentences. Okay. Now, subject pronoun. We use this in the singular. I, you, he, she and it. We use plural. We, you and they. All right. Now, when we move on to the pronoun part. Okay. I am sure this is your course book exercise. See, children, the exact sentences are not going to come from here. All right. So you, that is what I'm telling you. You need to understand the concept in grammar. Pronouns, you know what are pronouns. Okay. So I'll just take you through this. I, you, he, she, it, they, them, and her. Okay, so these pronouns are used in place of nouns. I am playing football. You are playing. So instead of you, we give a name for it, right? Okay. Now we move on to the exercise part of it. Now let me explain to you. I'm sure. See, I am sure I left my purse here. Now, like the individual here, I am sure I left, and here I talks about a thing here. I left my purse here. So when you want to insert a pronoun, a suitable pronoun, now I cannot find it. So for thing, we use it. Got it clear? All right. As I've given you examples also, it rained heavily. Okay, so don't look for Rajesh and Dave. Now, children, there are two names over here. So it doesn't come under the singular form. It comes under the plural, more than two persons, two or more than two. So you need to use they have already gone home. Don't look for Rajesh and they. They have already gone home. Both of them are gone home. So you use the pronoun, correct pronoun here. They have gone home. Okay. Tina looks so pleased. Now Tina is a girl. So you want to continue the sentence. She has been selected for the main part in the school play. Now children, these same sentences will not come for you. You need to read and understand and apply the correct suitable pronoun in the given sentences which comes to you in Google Forms. Okay. Karan missed the football trials today. Karan is a boy, right? So he has missed the football trials. So Karan is a boy. In place of a noun, we use he. All right. He has been called tomorrow. Right. Are you going for Sana's birthday party? Are you going for Sana's birthday party? Two of my best friends have left school. Now here, two of my best friends. So friends are here, plural. So for plural, I really miss them. Understood? I wonder where Reena is. Now I wonder where Reena, girl, okay, is. I have something important to tell her. So in place of, you can't put she there, want to tell her. So all this comes under the pronoun part of your course book. All right. Now we move on to relative pronoun. Children, grammar part is very important for you to understand the concept in this. First, you need to understand. So first, what we learned, colloquial language. Okay. We have learned colloquial form. where the writers write it and the readers, it will be easy for the readers to read. Okay, next we have learned pronouns. I, you, he, she, it, they. Okay, and now we are moving on to relative pronoun. So if you know what is a pronoun, you'll be able to, you need to understand the concept in relative pronoun. Now, the concept is the words that who, whom, whose, which, all these act as relative pronouns in a given sentence. Okay, the words that, who, whom, whose, which act as relative pronouns. So what are relative pronouns? So this connects the noun and the phrase. The relative pronoun refers to the noun that has gone before it. Okay, we'll see some examples now. Many examples are not given in your book. I've given you a very clear picture of who, which, whose, whom, that. Okay, so who is used for people? Who is used for people? The woman who called you yesterday wants to buy the house. Okay, which, used for things and animals. Keep in mind, which is used for things and animals. Did you see the letter which came today? Did you see? So it's a thing, right? I love the puppy which is jumping at the kitchen. Now here is denoting animal. So you use which there. So which could be used for things and animals. So it might be asked, I love the little kitten which is jumping on the floor. So which is the relative pronoun? So who, which, whose, whom, that are all relative pronoun. The concept for who is, where do you apply that? You apply that for people. Which you apply that for things and animal. Whose you apply that for position of people and animals. Whose? He's a man whose opinion I respect. He's a man whose opinion I respect. She's the student whose handwriting is the best in the class. She's the student who stood first in school. Okay, so these kind of sentences will be asked. It will be twisted and asked for you. You must know to apply it in the correct sentence. Okay, so whose is used for position, for people and animals. Whom is used for people when the person is the object of the verb. The author whom you criticized in your review has written a letter in the reply. Okay, so now that is used for people, things and animal. People, things and animal. The girl that we met in France has sent us a card. Okay, the girl that I met yesterday in London had sent me a good message today. All right, so this is how it's going to be asked. Used for people, things and animals. The girl, or you can say the boy that I met yesterday in London had sent me his wedding card. All right, so we live in a ground floor flat that backs onto a busy street. Okay, so do you like the cat that is sleeping underneath the table? So here denoting animals. I think so. My slides are very clear for you to understand. All right. Okay, children, my time is up for now. I'll wind up the class and see you in the next class, children. Next class, I will be doing a grammar revision for you, poem and grammar. Okay, children? Thank you, children.